thus always being afraid that death will come and destroy my enjoyment. So these kleshas are destroyed gradually by Vajra Kriya. The six kinds of unsteady bhakti or Vajra Kriya are first Utsaha Mayi, that is, sometimes very enthusiastic, appearing enthusiastic, but this enthusiasm is based on not spiritual things. Like I'm first coming to school and the teacher says, oh, look at this book. A is for apple, B is for ball, C is for cat. Now here's the test. So I'm not knowing anything, just looking at pictures, but I can see by the picture, this is A apple, B ball, C cat. The teacher says, you're such a wonderful student. Then gradually the subjects get more hard, and I have more difficulty, and the teacher twists my ears. When the teacher says, you're such a wonderful student, I'm so enthusiastic. But upon being chastised, my false ego tells me to say, I don't like this school, I don't want to go. So Utsaha Mayi is false enthusiasm based on false ego. Then Gana Tarala. Sometimes my concentration or absorption in the name in scriptures is very great. It's very condensed. Gana, like a cloud. And sometimes it's Tarala, very diluted, because the subject matter may be hard or my mind is very flickering. So sometimes condensed interest and sometimes very diluted interest. And then Vyuta Vikalpa, or fighting against sense gratification. I vow that I'm not going to take sweets because it makes my mind uncontrolled. But then so many nice halava and other sweets come, and then I think, I'll start tomorrow. So fighting and not succeeding in the fight against sense gratification, although trying. And then unsteadiness of mind. That is, I will get married, I won't get married. I will get married, I won't get married. If I execute marriage life properly as a serious grihastha, I'll make advancement in Krishna consciousness by respecting my spouse as, my spouse is a servant of Krishna, not for my enjoyment. So I'll assist them and we'll both advance in Krishna consciousness. And if I'm in the renounced order, practicing bhakti without any attachment, certainly I'll make advancement. But in this stage of indecisiveness, I can neither get the benefits of renounced life, nor can I get the benefits of serious grihastha life. I go in my mind constantly. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is married, so I should also be married. But Sukadeva Goswami wasn't married, so I shouldn't be married either. But all the members of the Panchatattva were married, so I should be. But if I don't get married now, later on when I get old and I haven't gone through Varnashram properly, then I'll be attached to get married when I'm 60 or 70 years old. So maybe I should get married. In this way, being on the mental plane and not taking advantage of any ashram. And then, Taranga Rangani. Oh, inability to follow vows. Nema Akshama. That is, one is fighting against sense gratification, and one is and not being successful, and one is inability to follow vows. That is, I'm chanting 16 rounds now, but my Gurudev told me to increase it to 32 and even 64. He told me that I'll really only make advancement when I can chant 64 rounds, and Krishna will only accept my offering if I'm chanting sincerely 64 rounds. So I'm taking a vow, I shall chant 64 rounds. Then headache comes, cold comes, weakness comes, I'll start tomorrow. So attempting to follow vows, but inability. Niyama Akshama. And then finally, Tarangarangane, riding on the waves of the material facilities that I've gotten by my impure execution of bhakti. That is bhakti uta, an artist that come by the imperfect execution of bhakti. I give a good class. Somebody gives me $100 donation and tells me what a great class I gave. So I think, yes, I did give a good class. I should figure out how I should use this money for myself. But actually, if it was a good class, all the credit goes to my Gurudev. As we pray to the previous acharyas when we sing their songs, this is not my prayer. This is your prayer. You feel this prayer and you've realized it. For me, it's ink on a page or simply words. Please make your prayer my prayer. Please make my heart one with your words. Similarly, the class that I may give is not my class. If anything is good about it, the knowledge is my Gurudev's knowledge. I have no knowledge. I'm simply repeating syllables. Gurudev explained there are three kinds of preachers. Those who simply repeat words, those who are in Ravanuga.
Oh, please come on subject.
Okay. So Tarangarangane.
Direct from subject. Okay. I want that you should tell about bhajan kriya, not the fruit of bhajan. What you are telling, this is the fruit of nishtha or other things, not bhajan kriya. So please come on subject.
Bhajan kriya means the activities of devotional service. There are 9 processes of devotional service. Shravanam, kirtanam, smaranam, thinking about Krishna, hearing about Krishna, remembering about Krishna, serving his lotus feet, engaging in deity worship, carrying out the orders. All these activities are activities of bhajan, activities of bhakti. Attending Mangalarti in the morning is an activity of bhajana kriya. Waking up in the morning and first thing I do is I remember my guru parampara, Jai Sri Sri Guru Gauranga, remembering the qualities of each of the personalities in that Guru Parampara and praying that whatever qualities he has, he'll give those qualities to me so I can execute my bhakti properly. Then attending Mangalarti and praying that I can enter deeply into the meaning of Mangalarti as described by Param Gurudev, the deep meaning of the awakening of Radha and Krishna. Chanting. Gurudev said, if you simply chant Hare Krishna, you'll be full of material desires. Doesn't seem to make any sense. But the meaning is, I must sing the bhajans, the songs. Because by singing the songs and praying to the personalities who wrote the songs, that my heart can become one with theirs, my desires change from matter to spirit, so that when I chant the Hare Krishna mantra, my desires are spiritual. And I start to think like Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, take away my envy, let me desire to take birth in Vrishabhanupura. So many spiritual desires come when I regularly sing these songs. And regularly hearing class. Gurudev is instructing everywhere he goes that whatever community is there locally, and I'm part of that community, I must attend the functions of that community. If it's not possible, then I must attend the functions on my own. I told him once, Gurudev, I have so much service for you, so my chanting and hearing becomes more sloppy because I'm so busy with my deadlines. So he said, no, you must be just like me. I'm so busy all day preaching and writing, but I always take time to chant and to weep. So you should also take that time.
Thank you. Bhaktisar, Bhakti Sar Maharaj will speak on the point. Very good. Thank you.
Shrimadeva has ordered me to speak on this subject of Bhajana Kriya. According to Srila Vishwanatha Chakrabarti Thakur, the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam.
Why not Goswami? The original?
I understand.
He has commentary.
He has also commentary.
Vishwanatha Chakrabarti, but really coming from Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami. So you can use word Rupa Goswami.
I'm not prepared for that, really. What's that?
Don't fear.
Srila Vishwanatha Chakrabarti Thakur, in his Madhurya Panambini, he has described the verses of Srimad Bhagavatam, second canto, first canto, Shrimadasa Katha Krishna, Punyashravana Kirtana, that there are three stages of Bhajana Kriya. First comes this Anishtita Bhajana Kriya described by Srimati Shamarani Didi, the unsteadiness and all those features we heard about characterizing that unsteadiness. Then will come Anartha Nivritti. This stage means the cleansing of unwholesome.
I want that you should begin from Anartha Devi and what is.
Bhakti,
yes, Bhajan Kriya.
He says that.
Jiren Anarthi is there.
And after that, he says Nishtha Bhajan Kriya comes.
No, I want from beginning. If a man is full of so many Anarthas, lakhs and millions, how should he? What is good for him to do? For him, what Bhakti Kriya? Bhajan Kriya.
He'd better find a guru and take shelter of him.
I should say, or you should say. Go on.
If he's not unqualified, Kurdev, anyone will need guru, but especially if someone is so unqualified, how will they know what to do?
Or you should tell to others.
I'm sorry, you know, I'm not quite sure I didn't understand where you want this to go, because covered the topic of Anishtita Bhajana Kriya. Oh, Guru Parashrani.
Oh, so you should see. Oh, you.
Om Gyan Niranjasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chakshuru So what is Bhajana Kriya? Bhajana Kriya means activities of bhajan in the conditioned state. The conditioned living entity is covered by so many types of ignorance. There are so many types of anarthas and there is so many problems. Actually, to do bhajan properly, it is not possible for someone in the conditioned state. Therefore, the very first thing one must do, Ada Guru Padashraya.
Oh, very good.
From the beginning, one must take shelter. Padashraya. One must take shelter at the lotus feet of Sri Gurudev. And under the guidance of Sri Gurudev, only then one can begin the process of Bhajana Kriya. Bhajana Kriya begins at the time Diksha Kale, at the time one has received Diksha from a bona fide Guru. Nowadays, some people are saying, no need of Guru, we can accept any great Acharya, Srila Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj, or Srila Prabhupada, or we can accept any Vaishnava, no need that they are present before us. But no, according to Bhagavad Gita, tadvidhi pranipatena parikrishnena sevaya upadekshati te jnanam jnanenas tattva darshanaha. How can we serve Srila Rupa Goswami? How can we serve any Vaishnava who is not present before us? How can we fall at his feet? Oh, my Gurudev is here, I will fall at my feet. What does it mean, pranipat? It means to offer dandavat pranam. Dandavat, ashtanga dandavat pranam. It means to what? Offer my head, my body, mind, words, intelligence, everything I'm giving at the lotus feet of my Gurudev. And then Gurudev will engage the disciple in bhajana kriya. Now you should do something. So some persons, they came once to Srila Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj at Suryakund. And he gave them some instruction. Oh, you should grow eggplant. And they were thinking, oh, what is this? We came here, we wanted to do some bhajan and remember Ashtakali Alila, but he is instead engaging us in growing eggplant. Why? Because Gurudev knows the heart of the disciple. And Gurudev will take that disciple who may have so many anarthas and who is in ignorance, unable to see the proper path, and will engage that disciple properly so that they can come into the path of bhajan. So there is some discussion also. What is Swarup Siddha Bhakti and other activities? How other activities which are not included even in the 64 items of bhakti, how they are also Swarup Siddha Bhakti? Why? Because Swarup Siddha Bhakti means, according to what is the intrinsic nature of bhakti, which is Anukulyena Krishnanu Shilanam Bhakti Ruptama. Uttama Bhakti is defined intrinsically. That Swarup Lakshan, the intrinsic characteristic of bhakti, is that it is meant exclusively for the pleasure of Sri Krishna. So actually, we are praying to taking shelter of Gurudev because why? Because he knows how to please Krishna, how to please Mahaprabhu, how to please Radha and Krishna. This is real bhajan. Real bhajan means, like the six Goswamis are doing, He Radhe Rajadevi Ke Chilalite He Nanda Suno Kutaha Sri Govardhana Kalpa Pada Patale Kalindi Vandye Kutaha Goshanthavati Sarvato Rajapure Kedar Mahave Halao Vande Rupa Sanatana Raghu Yuga Sri Jiva Gopalakao. They were in so much distress. They were going everywhere in Braj saying, where is Krishna? Where is the son of Nanda Maharaj? Where is Sri Radha? Where are the gopis? Where is Lalita, Vishaka? They are going everywhere, Govardhan, Radhakund, everywhere. And they are weeping day and night. Someone is saying that someone may be chanting three lives, like Namacharya Srila Haridas Thakur. But who is higher? Oh, Srila Rupa Goswami, he may be chanting only one syllable, not even one name of Krishna. And he is falling unconscious. This is real bhajan. Oh, but we cannot touch this. We cannot even come close to this concept of bhajan. So, by taking shelter at the lotus feet of Sri Gurudev, he will engage us and he will give us some instruction that we should do these activities. We should sing these bhajans. Why? So that we are praying that the moods of our acharyas, they may come in our heart, that the moods of my Gurudev. Who is my Gurudev? Oh, I am thinking of my Gurudev always. In what form? Oh, I am seeing my Gurudev coming before me like this, but actually he is serving Radha and Krishna, always giving pleasure to Radha and Krishna. In this form, always I am praying that my Gurudev will somehow give me entrance into bhajan, because bhajan is the root of bhakti. Bhajan means bhajate, means how to worship properly, but bhajan is not emotional service, doing everything for the pleasure of Sri Krishna. So, in this way, we can begin to come from the conditional stage and we can begin to follow the angas of bhakti as Chamarani Jini was describing. Sravanam kirtanam vishnu smaranam paratevanam arsanam bandhanam dasyam sakhyam atma nirvedanam iti pum sarpita vishnu bhaktis chendal vatthina lakshana kriyeta bhagavati adha kanmane dhitam uttamam. So under the guidance of Sri Gurudev, we are engaging in these processes of bhakti and directly offering our life energy, our everything, at the lotus feet of Sri Radha and Krishna. And in this way, our human life can become successful. Hare Krishna.
What is the meaning of Guru Padashraya? What is the meaning?
Jnananjana-sarakaya-chakshu-gandhita-vaya-tasmai-sri-bhavaya-vaya. So bhajan and kriya means to take full sheltered lotus feet of
bona fides.
Bhajan and kriya means to take full sheltered lotus feet of bona fide sadguru, and under the guidance of bona fide sadguru, engage in the 64 limbs of devotion. So we should know very clearly what is guru pada ashraya. So, so the guru, there are two types of Bhagawan. One is Vishai Bhagawan, the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Vishai Bhagawan, he is the enjoyer. But there is another form of the Supreme Personality of Godhead in this world. This is called Ashraya Bhagawan, or the bona fide Mahabhagavat, Guru Pada Padma Vaishnava. Ashraya Bhagawan indicates he is the form of Bhagawan upon which the jiva should take shelter. Chakudan Dilojay Janme Janme Prabhu said, the disciple should feel in his heart very deeply, I am an eternal servant of the spiritual master. I am his eternal servant. He is my eternal Lord. So we should examine ourselves very, very deeply. Have I reached the feet of Guru Parapadma? Krishna says, Nanda Baptist, Krishna says, one who calls himself my devotee, he is not my devotee. But one who calls himself a devotee of my devotee, he is my real disciple, he is my real servant.
In Bhakti Rasam Sindhu, clearly it has been told, Guru Padashaya and Diksha Siksha. Why it has divided in two sections? So you should try to, what? So Guru Padashaya, what is that? What is Diksha Siksha? Padashaya means to take Harinam. And know that my life will be successful if I am in his guidance. O Gurudev, I will obey you. I will try to know your wishes and try to follow. Man Bhishti. I don't know anyone, even not God. Through you I am knowing that Krishna is Supreme Lord. Radhika is Shlaghanisham, or all these things. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is combined of Srimati Radhika and Krishna. I hear, but everything I can do only in your guidance, by your obeying words. So fully taking shelter, he will support, he will nourish, he will save me from worldly, chain of birth and death. So So I am going to take his shelter. This is called Guru Padashya. Then he will not look here and there. Don't disobey. You should choose a guru who is surely a fan of heart, who is in the line of his Gurudev. He is in the line of Gurudev. He is doing bhajan in the guidance of his guru and guru parampara. Giving proper respect to all. Has no worldly desire. He is fully detached, knowing all the meanings, hidden meaning of all the shastra, not knowing even he is realized. Then in whole lifetime you cannot give up him. But we see there are so many, but not guru, but Kangal. Really they are not guru. When you were initiated, first, you never examine me, but later on you saw and realize, oh, this guru cannot save me. He cannot give any benefit to me. He cannot teach me, oh, Krishna Bhakti, because he is himself not doing anything, not practicing. Oh, he cannot chant more than 16, sometimes 2 sometimes, sometimes, like this. No belief in his Gurudev. And later on, oh, he gives up the guidance of Guru and chanting everything. To disciple, he may tell, oh, I am Guru, bona fide Guru. But really, he is not. When a person will realize that, oh, this Guru is not really Guru, bogus, even he is not sincere, then he should be given up, doing pranama. And try to take shelter in a bona fide Guru. And if you are not doing, no bhakti. Only karma. Krishna will not sprinkle his dust. Oh, so many things that. Avaishnava mutkho girna putam. If he is not Guru, if he is not even a Vaishnava, and you will hear him, serve him, then like a cow is not giving milk, and you want milk from that cow. You want a fruit from a fruitless tree like bubble and thorns. How it will come? So we should take shelter in a Guru Padma. Who can give? Oh, Krishna consciousness. And that person is what? Real Eskom. I know that Swami Bhaktivedanta Swami Maharaj has told Krishna Bhakti Rasabhavita Mati Kriyatam Kutopi Jadi Labhate Tatpradol Janopi Mulleve Kalam Janu Koti Sukhati. Who is Eskom member? Who has this quality? Krishna Bhakti Rasabhavita Bhav Parashi. He can make all, inspire all in that. And if a Guru, a Vaishnava is found like that, oh, give your head and take shelter. This is taking shelter. Like Raghunatha, if your Guru, who cannot help you, but sincere, and Madhyam Adhikari, oh, he cannot give you Krishna thing. But if you pray him that, oh, please give me your permission that I should mix, I should associate a high class of Vaishnava, like Jiva Goswami, who told Shyamananda. And his Guru told, oh, I am very happy, very happy. Raghunath Das Goswami told to his Guru Dev Jadunanda Nachar. Oh, impressed him. Oh, at once. In Jaiva Dharma it has been written, what? They were told by his Gurudev, ordered himself, oh, you should go to Gopal Guru. And no less honor for his Gurudev, like equal. They are equal in all respect. So this is called Guru Padashi. And that or after that, what is Diksha and Shikshara? What is that? Diksha. He has taken Ashray. He is chanting name. But his name is not very qualified. So Gurudev wants that I should give him Diksha. Dibdivyanta. Passing all kinds of offenses, unwanted things. Like, we have heard that kasha. Kasha means? You should tell loudly. What?
Bell metal.
Oh, it is given some chemicals, it will be gold. So Gurudev gives this medicine or this chemical to his shishya. And then Divya Gyan comes. What is Divya Gyan? Krishna Parabrahma. jiva tattva, maya tattva, bhakti tattva, radha tattva, offense tattva. All there are so many things. He is expert and he is delivering to his disciples. And makes like him. Guru never makes any disciple. Our Gurudev, our Prabhupada, he had told, never a guru makes any disciple. I have not made any disciple. He makes guru. His all disciples were what? Guru, and they can. They could have whole world. You know, that Loknath Das Goswami, he made Raghunath Das Goswami guru, not disciple, Narottam Thakur. What name? Gopal Bhatta Goswami. Oh, he did not make him disciple. Any bona fide guru, he touched like a touch a stone and becomes cold. And he knows all kinds of tattva. And prerna karta hai. Inspire the disciple to know all these things. Yesterday I told, Gurudev told, oh, everything should come in you. And at once, a life miracle, wonder. And then, second, Kshā. We have so many anarths. So many. Shyamrani has explained something. More life. Bhikshe. Aprithiparti. Prasaya. And after that, all so many. Even. So many things. We want to discuss, but we have not so much time. But we will explain here or there or anywhere. And you should try to take all these things. Then, Kshā, Diksha. And then, Sikshana. What is Sikshana? What Sikshana? Very deep subject. Sikshana. You know, Raghunath Das Goswami went in the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And he told, I don't know all these things. And he took his hand and gave in the hands of and then he became Sarupayrahu. And what he did? Oh, made him like him. What we see? Rupa Goswami has given only theory. But Raghunath Das Goswami has how, in what proportion they should be mixed. Rupa Goswami has not told. In Manashiksha, in his all books, in what proportion, what will be given, then it will be Surasa. Surasa means? Oh, like rush. In India we tell some sugar, some water, some kevada or lemon. We mix and then it becomes very tasteful, like nowadays very lemonade does not. Coca-Cola. All cannot make things. They don't know combination. So, Rupa Goswami has to hold rasa. And he has produced rasa and given rasa. But how this rasa will come? Oh, Raghunath Das Goswami. Also, Jiva Goswami and other Goswami has to. If you will give 1 kilo sugar and 1 glass of water only and some salt, then what it will be? But if you will give 1 kilo sugar, 5 kilo water, and 1 or 2 only lemon, and then it will be very hot. So Raghunath Das Goswami has explained what and how and in what way we can make bhakti to bhakti rasa. All the acharyas, previous acharyas, like Ramanuja, Madhva, Vishnu Swami, Nimbaditya, all they produced and taught bhakti. Prahlad Maharaja has taught also bhakti. All has explained about bhakti, but not bhakti rasa. Only Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and his associate, Sri Rupa Goswami and others, very special Manubhishta Pura, they have done this. We are very lucky to come in this line of Guru Parampara. Very, very lucky. I feel very proud of coming in this line. And you should also. But not only thinking and proud of being this, but following totally. Then it will be siksha. What he, Raghunath Das Goswami, learned from Jiva Goswami. Sarup Dhamma, what he learned? What he has told? In Guru. Everything. Guru, Guru Goste, Gostale, Sujane, Sursurgane, Swamantresi, Namni, Vrishma, Danta, Sarani, Sada, Dampam, Hitva, Kuru, Ratima, Purvam, Atitaram, Aye, Kata. He has not told to anyone, but he has told to human being and to his heart. Oh, this is bhakti. Guru gives mantra. Please, but respect our Gurudev, and in same way, siksha. Gurudev can give diksha. Sometimes he cannot give siksha because a disciple should honor him always. And he cannot tell so many things that should be told. We have so much honor for Gurudev, as for Jiva. So, Diksha Guru sometimes, he cannot tell so many confidential things. But Siksha Guru, like a brother, like a bosom friend, keeping that disciple embracing, and he will tell so many things that in Uchvali money has been given. So this is Shikshanam. Like Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he went to Vrindavan and he was returning from Vrindavan. And when he came on 3 rivers, that is Prayag, Rupa Goswami met, and he knew from before him, he met Ram Kaligram, and he has told that, you remember this fact? That I am going to tell. So, when Rupa Goswami met him, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, I have to tell you something, inspire. Bhakti is like a ocean, bhakti rasa. And, it is so deep, endless. Unlimited. But I'm telling only one drop. Not only one drop, one sprinkle. Atom of that bhakti antena. And if you have By this you can whole universe you will conquer. And all will be flooded. Anyone cannot be saved. All will be sinking in that ocean of rush. They cannot come up. Always taking and drinking the nectar. And then he, in Prayag, he told, Adau Guru Padashayam Sikhyanam Ten, which is the root of bhakti. And then more ten, which are not favorable, unfavorable. And those who are not favorable and not, especially those, the arms, those who are like bhava-mayi, bhava-sambandhi, bhava-nukul, bhava-viruddha, bhava-aviruddha. He told everything. I think that you are not understanding. I want to, but it will take time. So he told him. And then other, among 64. Bhakti is the unlimited, not only limbs of bhakti in 64. Unlimited. Rupa Goswami has selected and made easy. Like made grammar easy, and that he has made bhakti easy. And he has. So please try to understand all these things, the limbs of bhakti. And as he told, that essence of the whole limbs of bhakti is 64. And the essence of 64 is 9. And essence of 9 is 5. Very, very powerful. If anyone has no offense, then touching only even sadhusam naam kṛtam bhāgavatam maturāvā śrīmati śabdāyāsya. Only this will touch you, that this thing, and a prayer will come. So, and after that, he told, like Rupa Goswami perhaps told, afterward, Tannāma Rūpa Charitādi Sukritanān Anukramena Rasanā Manasī Tishthan Braje Tadānurāgi Janānugāmi Kāle Nared Ikhilam Ittu Padesha Sādhi. What? Tannāma Rūpa Charitādi. Can you define this?
Om Jnana Timiram Vasya Jnanam Jana Shalakaya Chakshurum Militam Yena Tasmani Sri Gurudeva. So Srila Gurudeva is referring to the 8th shloka of the Sri Upadeshamritam, which Srila Rupa Goswami gave the very essence of all teachings. So he is quoting this verse, Tannama Rupa Charitadi Sukirtananu Smrityo Kramena Rasana Manasi Niyodhya Tishtan Braje Tad Anuragi Jananugami Kalam Nayed Akilam Iti Upadesha Saram. This verse is very significant because Srila Rupa Goswami is telling that this is the Upadesh Sar, the very essence of all instruction summarized in this one shlok. So here he is telling that the essence of all advice is that one should utilize fully one's entire time, kalam, nayed, akilam. All of his 24 hours should be perfectly utilized in constantly tannama rupa charitadi su kirtananu. He should be constantly absorbed in kirtan and smrityo kramena, Rasana, manasi, niyojya, his tongue, his mind, all should be completely absorbed and merged in hearing and chanting and remembering the name, form, qualities, pastimes, and all of Sri Krishna. And he should perform this activity in a particular place, that is Vrindavan, Braja, Tishtan Braje. He should be living in Braj, and it is that special power of that particular location by which he can merge his whole thoughts and mind in the eternal pastimes of Krishna. So if one cannot live in Braj physically, still one has to live in Braj within his mind and within his heart. Tishtan Braje, tad anuragi jananugami. He must be in Braj performing this kind of bhajan, nam bhajan, under the guidance, not independently. Here it says, tad anuragi jananugami. So the anuragi jan, these are the eternal associates of Krishna in the eternal Goloka Vrindavan Dham. They are serving Krishna with eternal ragatmika prem. That means his associates, like Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, Sridham, Subal, Madhu Mangal, and Lalita Vishaka, all the gopis, and Srimati Radhika in topmost position. All of these eternal associates of Krishna have ragatmika prem, eternal natural devotion for Krishna. And those who are following their moods within this world, who are actually performing seva sadaka rupena siddha rupena chatrahi, that they are internally completely absorbed in following their moods and worshipping their bhavs and the way that they love Krishna in their particular mood of Krishna praying. So those personalities in this world, they are called the anugami jam. They are following the moods of the eternal associates of Vrindavan. And all of our acharyas in our life, beginning with Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, and all of our Gaudiya acharyas, they are in this category. So Rupa Goswami is telling that one has to be living in Vrindavan, performing this bhajan under the guidance of such personalities. He says, Kalam Nayed Akilam Ityupadesha Saram. If someone utilizes his full 24 hours daily in this way, under this kind of guidance, living in Braj, then he will be able to perfectly attain the goal of pure bhakti, and that is Krishna Prem, Braja Prem.
Explain the slope of Manashiksha, Guru, that from Madhav Maharaj. That's plain. Very brief, not taking so much time.
One
thing right now, may tell you, request you, that what nectar Vaishnavas are giving, oh, there should be no, there is no any cost in this world. Nothing. If it really, priceless, out of cost, what they are giving. If you touch only a sprinkle of that, bottom of that, your life will be successful. So no price is there. And you are here. So I request you, for this, you should pay something for this festival. Alone anyone cannot do. It is very heavy for one person to do. So those who are really poor, for them I will pay. They should not pay. But if there are some money with them, they can host in hotel and spend so much money for a good meal and all these things. For taking a car, coming to renting car, why they cannot give some 2, 3, 4 $2, $3, I think they should think about it. I don't want to take more time in this. Now go.
Omagyanatimidandasya jnananganasalakaya chaksurunmilitam yena tasmai sigurave namaha. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. As the Gurudev command me to discuss about first slok of Manasiccha compiled by Sri Raghunath Das Goswami, which you have heard from Sri Gurudev, who was Sarupe Raghu, Raghu of Raghunatha, Sri Sarup Damodar. His mind was not uncontrolled. In one hand, he was eternal associate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and other hand, eternal associate of Divine Kapil. Being so, he acting in this world like an ordinary sadhak to teach us how we can develop in Krishna consciousness. So he being kasthes merciful, why? Tripaya vidyavan deha, vidyavan deha. Seeing our misery, his heart became melt. So he composed Manasiccha. Guru goshthe goshthalayesu sujane bhusuragane samantre srinamni brajanugajivadanda sarane sadadammam hitva kurati mapurvam atitaram ay santa bhavatascharuvi abhijachindhita padah. Guru goshthe. Srila Dasa Goswami is praying his mind not to others. Oh my mind, please follow all this thing. Why? Mana eva manusanam karanabandha mokchaye. The mind is the root of all evil. If his mind is controlled, then mind is the best friend of the world. If mind is not under your control, then the best foe, not friend, foe. So Das Goswami is telling, Guru Goshthe. Guru means to Guru Pad Padma. Here Guru Pad Padma means Diksha Guru and Shiksha Guru. Just like you heard from Srila Gurudev, Guru Padashraya, first Harinam initiation, and Harinam is meant to make the Harinam perfect, that Harinam should manifest in our tongue, have to take initiation. Without initiation, it is not possible that Harinam will make dance on our tongue. So, Guru, who has given Diksha, and from you are taking Siksha. Sometime, Diksha Guru will be Diksha Guru and Siksha Guru. Sometime, Diksha Guru is separate, different personality, and Siksha Guru is different personality. No problem. So, we have to increase Rati, both of their lotus feet. Goshthe. Goshthe means go plus tha goshtha, who lives in Braj, where go, gopi, gopibala, etc. The leaves, that place called goshtha. So who lives in goshtha means Brajavasi. We have to increase rati towards them. But which mood you want? He had to increase more rati towards that kind of Brajavasi. If you are Sokharas, then have to increase on more towards Siddham, Subal, etc. If Vatsala, then Nanda, Yasoda, etc. If Paramar mood, then Lalita, Visakha, and Sadhika. Among them, if you want Tattva Dhavetchami, then Rupmanjari, Ratimanjari, etc. For this, Das Goswami told, Sripa Manjari Kala Chita Pada Padma, etc. All these things. Goshthe. Goshtha means Braj. In Vrindavan, where all the leaves, that place is called Goshtha. And Goshtha Laisu, who lives in that Braj, for them called Goshtha Laisu, like which I explained just now. And Sujane. Sujane means if they are not Brajavasi, they have not any particular mood for Krishna, but they are living in Braj from other sampradaya. They are called Sujan.
We have to respect them also because they have taken shelter exclusively in Braj, though they are from other sampradaya. Sujani, Bhusuragani. Bhusur means Brahman. So, who lives in Braj, they are not doing bhajan properly. Not one pointed bhajan towards divine couple, but came in Brahmin family living in Braj. We have to respect them also. If you don't respect, this is not proper etiquette. So, Sujani Bhusuragani. Moreover, Samantre. Samantra is Sam means own. Mantra means mantra. Which own mantra? Which Gurudev has given mercifully during initiation? Gayatri, Brahma Gayatri, Guru Mantra Guru Gayatri, Gaur Mantra Gaur Gayatri, Gopal Mantra Kam Gayatri, Panchavata Mahamantra, etc. So we have to every day chant without any fail. I ask some devotee, now what is going on? Mantra? No, no, we have to do every day. If we not do so, just like for maintaining our body, we have time to take prasad. But why not time? For chanting our Gayatri mantras and Harinam? Yes, we are very busy, we know, but still we have to do all these things. Some mantra. Moreover, Sri Namni. Sri Namni means Sri Harinam. For the mantra will give you the sambandha again. Which mantra we are chanting, it will give us sambandha again and to make Harinam pure, to make dance on your tongue. So we have to give importance Sri Namni. Sri Namni means, Sri means Sri Nam, Sri Yukta Nam. Sri means Srimati Radhika, Nam means Krishna, Nam Nami Abhed. So I have to chant Radha and Krishna Supatna means Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Sri Namni. Moreover, Brajanubhajavadandasarane means the divine couple of Braj. We have to take shelter and increase our roti towards them. Because we are doing all these things for whom? To get eternal service of divine couple. So we have to increase our roti towards them. How? Sada dhamma hitva have to give up our false ego. Dasgasam had not false ego at all. Sometime if we get any chance, we become so much puffed up. We think, oh, which we are, now how I became. He has to give up his all false ego. Sada dhamma mitva, kuru roti ma purva mati taram, apurva roti, unprecedented roti, which he has not increased as before. Being in sadhu sangha, then you can understand all these things. Mati taram, very quick, don't delay. Then what will be? Then we can advance in Krishna consciousness. And for which purpose Dasa Goswami wrote this? And which he received from Sri Rupa Goswami and Sarupa Damodar Prabhu? That we can get this thing and we can make our asset in our heart. And in their guidance and in their mood, under guidance of Guru Pada Padma, like Guru Pada Padma is following his Gurudev and is serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu divine couple, we can do so, then our life will be successful. For this reason, Dasa Goswami being causeless merciful, compile this love. Hare Krishna.
This is the essence of Srila Rupa Goswami teaching. But the essence of this also, Srila Vishwanath Thakur, the after all, Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Goswami, who came, succession of them. Srila Vishwanath Chakravarti Thakur has told, Aradhyo Bhagavan Praje Satanaya Taddham Vrindavan Ramya Kachudu Parsana Vaju Vadu Varge Naja Kalpita Srimad Bhagavatam Pramamamalam Premapumartho Mahan Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam Tatradaro Nāpara. Oh, explaining you. Essence, Mali, because time is over.
not so important. Om Jnanati Varandasya Jnanandana Salakya Chakshur Nuritam Jena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. Srila Vaishnava Chakrita Thakur, by this verse, he has summarized the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, which have been expounded and elaborated upon by his intimate associates such as Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Das Goswami, Jiva Goswami. Here specifically, he has categorized the entirety of the teachings of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu into five aspects. First of all, Aradhya Bhagavan Brajesha Thanaya. Who is our Aradhya? The object of our love and affection. Aradhya Bhagavan Brajesha Thanaya. Not this Bhagavan in his aspect of Aishwarya, that is Narayan, or even in his aspects of Aishwarya and Madhurya both together, like Mathuresh Krishna. No. Aradhya Bhagavan Brajesha Thanaya. It means, Thanaya means the natural born son of the king of Braj. So here he is indicating Lokik Sambhat Sambandha, very natural and affectionate relationship with Krishna. Aradhya Bhagavan Brajesha Thanaya Taddama Vrindavanam. And as Krishna is to be loved, similarly his Dham Vrindavan is not less worthy of our love and affection. This Vrindavan is the Kridastali of Radha and Krishna. There is Giraj Govardhan, Jamuna, Bhansi Bhakt, Nidvan, Seva Kunj, all of these places. So as you love Krishna, or have affection for them, as Raghunath Das Goswami's father said, go stay. You should love those places of Brajamanda. Because the dust of that place, every dust is completely saturated with the sweet Madhurya Rasa of the Vilas of Radha and Krishna. So, even Krishna himself, without going to the forest of Vrindavan, he cannot fulfill his desires, what to speak of us. So, Aradhya Bhagavan Brajesha Thanayas Taddhama Vrindavanam. Okay, now we have learned that we should love Krishna and his Vrindavan Dham. But by what method? Ramya Kachit Upasana Brajabadu Bargena Jakalpita. He's saying, oh my dear brothers, employ the method of worship or service, the method of ecstatic, spontaneous love that the gopis of Vrindavan have employed in their loving service to Krishna. Brajavadu. Brajavadu. Vadu means they are new brides. They are young and they have just been married to someone else, not to Krishna. So this indicates following the Parakya Rasa Bhakti. Accepting Krishna as Paramo. Tameva Paramatmanam Jarabuddhi Apisangataha. Jarabuddhi. Except Krishna is one's paramo. Where will we learn about these things? Now we know who is the object of our love, who is the place where his pastimes are taking place, the method of love. We know who is the object of our love. These things. Who is the place where his pastimes are taking place, the method of love. From where can we learn these things? Is there any evidence? Yes. Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam. This spotless, immaculate, perfect evidence. Where we can learn about this, that is Srimad Bhagavatam. Where if you look towards Srimad Bhagavatam, we will see in the 10th canto, chapter 21, Venu Geet, the gopis Purvarag. How they love Krishna, how they have such intensity of hankering to meet with him before having the chance to ever meet with him. This is their Purvarag. Well, we find it in Srimad Bhagavatam. And their separation moods were in Gopi Geets, Srimad Bhagavatam, chapter 30. And, Radhika's Mahabhav, Rudra Bhav, Adhi Rudra Bhav, Mohan Bhav. You'll find Srimad Bhagavatam where? Brahmar Geets. And Madanaki Mahabhav also. All of the moods of gopis of Braja have been described by Shukadeva Goswami in Srimad Bhagavatam. It has not been described in the other Shastras. All of our Goswamis, they've written so many things, but on the basis of this, Jiva Goswami gave six Sandarbhas, all explaining Bhagavatam. Gopal Champu explaining Bhagavatam, Pramsandhava explaining Srimad Bhagavatam. Sarvasambhadini Tika explaining Bhagavatam. In this way, the followers of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu have tried to manifest Mahaprabhu's teaching. That is, that the love of the gopis of Vrindavan, especially Radhika, have been described there in Srimad Bhagavatam. This Bhagavatam was written, was manifesting this whole by Vyas, only to glorify the love of Radhika. Ultimately, this was the purpose. So Srimad Bhagavatam, Pramana Mamalam, Prema Pumarto Mahan, and the Param Purushata, Panchim Purushata, the supreme valuable acquisition that is the highest goal of everyone's life, that which is to be attained, the prayojan, is this Braja Prem following in the footsteps of the gopis of Braj. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu Matamidam, this is the opinion, the mata, this is the conception of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Tatra Rana Para. I have no inclination or respect for anyone else's misguided opinion.
And what it is? Sri Rasadhanatan Goswami has told. Oh. If he wants that Parakiya mode of gopis, and he wants to serve Nandanandan, Rajendanandan, oh, then you will have to or chant the holy name. And what is that? A mantra can take you to Golok Vrindavan. Oh, he can give Samadha Gyan and fly away. So if you want to go and stop there, then Sri Krishna Govinda Hare Mukund Govinda Hare Nanda
Govinda,
all the Braj Gopi wake up in the morning. And what they do? But how? Smitva Yashodasuta Balike Uthaya Gopyo Pararatri Bhaga Smitva Yashodasuta Balike Gayanti Gopyo Janita Anuraga Govinda Namo Bhajan Kriya or all of these. So, I think you are lucky to hear all these things. And also very lucky to tell you. Very good. Now, our classes in LA this year, we are finishing here. I think that you should take some remnant of all these very sweet part and very powerful in your pocket. Don't keep it in your pocket of your dresses. Keep it in this pocket. And then, oh, Radha and Krishna, Kanjival Devi, in your heart or ether, this is the essence of all the bhajan pranali. Beyond this, I don't know anything. Go, prema.
My heart like flowers thousands and thousands of times.